All right, sounds good. I'll see you, or talk to you after the match, I guess. Good luck, man. All right, does he have any... He does not have any stadium enhancements. Do I have any? I don't remember. I do. It's always nice weather. 8-2-5. So now the question is... are we at his or mine? I don't remember. I don't have no money to buy any inducements anyway. Alright. I'm not sure on my chances here. My pieces are skilled up better than his, I think, right now. I can definitely do a lot more damage than he can, but his two wolves are gonna... Oh, we're at my stadium. Nice. His two wolves scare the absolute piss out of me, and he'll do a very good job of keeping his wolves out of harm's way. I think I want to receive and try to do damage early if I can. So, what I need to do is only allow him one hit per turn with those wolves. I do not want him getting hits.
Alright, so...
Oh, whoops, sorry. There we go. Get that reverb off. I don't know who had the what on fans. Fan factor. He rolled one higher than me in the actual roll. So it's going to be close. Neither one of us is going to get plus two. It's either going to be dead zero or plus one. I should have looked at the fan factor. Didn't even think about it. Guess we'll find out on the first kickoff event that uses fan factor or fame. All right. Yep, get those guys out. Leave me three rookie zombies to hit on. He's got enough zombies, he can leave me... he's got to leave me somebody to hit out here. See if my Mighty Blow can do some work this game. Be nice to get one casualty. TeamSpeak opened up here real quick, guys. There we go. Oop. Not what I wanted. So he's going to have to leave me somebody to hit, and it's that guy there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so I'm going to get two dies on both the guys on the side. Hopefully I take them down, and then I get three dice with the Crocs in the middle, and the Crocs gets a casualty and levels. That is the plan. 25 there, 18, 20. So let's get the 25 and 20 there. Oh, what's this guy? Strength 5. No mighty blow, though.
Gunter has connected.
The problem is, whichever guy I go up here to hit him with is...
ONI underscore Gaku has connected.
Gonna get clawed to death.
ONI underscore Gaku joined your channel.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up, man? So am I on the stream right now?
Yeah. Yeah, they can hear you.
Okay. Yeah, I'm feeling really good right about now.
Go ahead and have another beer.
All I need is two.
Gunter joined your channel.
What's up, Gunter?
What you up to?
Not much.
You playing?
We are.
What's the score?
Just starting.
No, what you
mean? OCC. A OCC. Euro League.
Y'all are multicultural.
Trying to be.
Crush Sam in a different league.
Is this new?
I think we both played one game, one season.
Alright, he gets the reroll, so he probably got fame then.
So yeah, 2 games ago, my block flesh golem took a minus strength, and my white took niggle, so...
Ah, damn it. That sucks.
Fortunately, the other one got block, and now I have the rookie flesh golem.
If I got fame, then I would have got the reroll. If we'd had even fame, we'd have both got one.
So they're new teams.
That sucks.
Oh, no, we both played one season.
Oh, okay.
No takedown there. That sucks.
No, his team is... I mean, I talked a little trash before our match started, but realistically, this game can go either way. Spider's a really good coach.
Let's go ahead and do the blitz here. We'll just keep our guys back. Let him get aggressive with the wolves. No break, though. That sucks.
Oh, I saw the werewolf, and I liked it.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I'm still working on the rest. So.
Not going to do that yet. That's the rookie there.
Damn you there.
He is moving this.
Yeah, I'm just taking my turn. Oh. We're just going to leave him right there.
One of the mummies goes to Sam, correct?
Oh, god damn.
Wait, what?
Billy?
Wasn't one of the mummies from years going to Sam?
Well, yeah, one mummy goes to him and one goes to me.
That sucked.
The regular mummies or the Kimmy looking mummies?
Well, the two regular mummies go to me. Is there only one of the special mummies?
No, there's two of them.
Yeah, two regular go to me. The two out of the two special ones, one goes to Sam, one goes to me.
Okay.
And then as far as how Sam wants it painted, I would talk to him.
That's what I was going to ask.
It's whatever, it's fine. I don't even remember what that big guy is.
An Egyptian-looking mummy that's like Tutton, the star player mummy.
Oh, okay. Red and dark blue are the two main colors for my Khemri team, Gunter.
Okay.
So anything close to that should fit in pretty decent.
Alright, I'll do all the stripes with red and dark blue.
And then since mine is a star player, whatever you decide is up to you.
I'll probably paint them both the same.
I can send you a couple images of my, a couple of my normal pieces if that will help you any.
Yeah, please.
I think I got pictures. Yeah, I still have pictures of them. I think I got them up on my photo bucket. I can send the links to you. I'll PM them to you in the forum.
Cool.
So he's going to go this route after the rookie. Assuming. Yeah, with the Mighty Blow piece.
You're the reason I couldn't take the name Death Jesters.
Yes.
I'm okay with him going after the rookie as opposed to my other guys.
And it gets deleted. Can you go use that name again?
Yes.
Somebody else must have stole my name. My original undead team was the Lords of Decay. Somebody has it.
So none of my Mighty Blow hits work. His Mighty Blow Qual doesn't work, so I'm okay with that if they stay even out like that. I'm certainly okay with that. I love the random wolf howl. That's so freaking awesome. Just hearing it in the background, that little random howl.
A double move Saurus. Cool.
Does the one die, but doesn't get away with it. Oh, he re-rolls it. Wow. Was that a misclick?
Yeah, I should not have re-rolled that.
Yeah, that was a lucky reroll there.
Come on, casualty.
If he casualties me, I'll be pissed. I was gonna say, absolutely lucky reroll there. All right, so first things first. Let's stand.
Hey, are you making Chaos Cup this year, Gunter?
Yes, I am.
All right, come on. Let's
so we get to see you and make fun of you.
There we go. Start getting some of these guys off of here.
I've already got money put aside for it.
So that'd be a two die. Want to get a hit on him.
I'm looking forward to Chaos Cup. I think I'll bring a 12 pack for everybody.
I stopped drinking.
Here.
Well, that's like two beers for me and 10 for everybody else.
Let's do that.
I thought you meant you bring everybody a 12-pack each.
Then oh, God, no. Hit. I know the last time I was there, there was about 12 of us.
I'm going to re-roll that. I'm going to greet it. Just so I can get the Mighty Blow
hit on. It's only six cases of beer.
And that was really mean.
You can do a carry-on. Just bring a keg.
Just bring a keg?
Yeah. Bring that great Texas beer called Lone Star.
Oddly enough, that's a really good beer if you want to marinate.
Or make beer canned chicken.
Oh, it works great for that. No, I get something from Thirsty Planet called Thirsty Goat that is really good. You know, Spider, you're not giving me all your secrets about why you're doing stuff.
You don't need them.
Are you streaming?
Yeah.
Don't you normally give tips while you're streaming?
I do, And I am talking while I'm streaming. He's just not on my stream.
Oh.
No, I got off his stream.
I don't want to do this go for it first.
Specifically so he could do whatever talking he would like to for his stream. This is going to be a skull and a casualty.
And I shouldn't have.
Oh!
Surprised I didn't break myself, to be honest. Usually when you do that, you end up breaking yourself.
There are times being a smartass can pay off.
Oops.
You didn't get the casualty, though.
Surprised I didn't break myself. Usually when that happens, you break yourself.
Yeah.
Wait, what the fuck? I chose the other...
That's interesting. You must have accidentally hit the other one by accident, thinking you hit the yellow but hit both down.
Yeah, because I had a chance at hitting your ball carrier.
You did.
Well, I'm trying to help you out, because I'd like to see two of the Americans make the move up.
That's the plan.
Well, that's the story I'm going to go with right now.
I played my first tabletop game Sunday, first time in 6 years.
Oh, a takeoff would have been nice.
How did that go?
I had three people show up, so I was just teaching them. So I threw out a chaos team and an orc team. And the guy tied it on turn 16, which was really cool. He had to make like six dodges with chaos.
Yeah, I played tabletop yesterday, Underworld, with two games versus a dwarf team. He got six casualties on me, but I still beat him 2-1.
Stand firm.
Well, that happens with Underworld, doesn't it?
More than what I would like, yes.
Because it's just goblins and Skaven, right?
Yeah, and his option for the Skaven, I mean, for the goblins were break armor or a casualty.
That's nice. I like. So I could do two die there. The rest of these guys, except for
Well,
him,
I went from a promising first half to in a lot of trouble.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah.
I really want to get that hit there. So what I got to do is do this hit. Oh, he's got guard. Shit. Well, that sucks.
I'm jonesing for some Blood Bowl because the seasons are in between.
Oh, man. What do I do here?
My playoff game didn't go that well.
My Proving Grounds didn't go well. My Stomping Fields, I've done well with.
Still in?
Yeah, and I'm playing Roller, who just got his... If you want to watch a good game, is watch the McLean versus Rollar, and that's a good Stomping Fields match.
I get the two die there. Then I get the three die here if I take him down, but that leaves my ball carrier right out in the middle, which is not good.
The guy who played with the Bretonians, he played a really good game with Bretonians.
That's the move 9. 1, 2, 3.
Versus dice were awesome.
4, 5, 6, 7.
He didn't fail one juggernaut. I mean, what the hell am I thinking? Dauntless. He never failed one dauntless against me.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, hey, I saw
six,
I get to play
seven,
you in USAB.
9, 10, 11.
What's that? Yeah. Great.
I'm playing Dark Elves.
Need to make a couple go-forts here. I'm going to get risky. Perfect.
You should be excited.
Oh, shit. I went to the wrong spot. Fuck. I meant to go there.
Yay. I'm playing my first game tomorrow morning.
That was pointless. Went to the wrong damn spot.
Oh, you wanted to be one more toward me?
So I get the assist. Ah, such a pain in the ass. My turn to fuck up. pay you back on.
Yeah, but at least it wasn't a block.
I can do the hit there, but I really want to do the hit here, and then blitz him to the sideline.
I think I'll replace the niggle guy as soon as I can get the money.
Ah, damn it. Come on.
Yeah, I'm playing Elphick tomorrow morning.
Well, good luck.
Thanks. I'll find a break with that orc team.
I still have the assist here.
Orc on orc.
Now I really need to get a yellow here, though.
Well, you're the only team I lost to last season.
Yeah, I screwed myself.
You're the only team I beat
on that turn. I just fucked that whole turn up. Oh, that was terrible, terrible play.
That's because you're amazing.
Absolutely terrible play, man. Oh,
see,
so
I'm trying
stupid.
To be nice there.
So stupid.
I need some tips on how to play Khemri. I keep trying, and I'm not very good at it.
I need to get my head out of my ass, guys. I mean, that was just
Roll well.
I shouldn't even make you guys have to sit there and watch play like that.
You keep guys in the back just in case.
I should have just went ahead and took the hit on him with my strength 5 because he's niggled, but... What are you going to blitz the...
Actually, a good coach to ask that advice on is...
Spider.
I didn't hear what you were saying. Sorry.
I need tips on how to play Khemri. I'm not doing very well trying to play him.
Ah! I can't be mad about that. I've taken several of his off. Pick up the ball and don't fail your pickups.
Great, thanks.
Now, the core thing with Khemri is learning how to position. And the more you play him, the more you're going to learn about positioning and understand positioning. Because they're one of the biggest teams about having to be able to position correctly in order to win.
UPS delivery has left the server. Zombie has left the server.
Swill was making the comment, they're probably the ultimate positioning team.
They are. Especially once you get them skilled right. Come on. Once you get them skilled right, that's the whole team is about positioning. And if you position well with them, the worst you're going to get in any game is a draw. Once you get them skilled right.
Well, what's your normal starting build?
Starting build, it depends on where I'm playing, but usually what I'll do is the 4 Tomb Guardians is a must. You have to have those. If you're not familiar with them, you should really start with 3 rerolls, which means you're only starting with both Blitz Ra's or both Throw Ra's or one of each. I don't like starting with only one Blitz Ra because you're already limited with block pieces on that team. I think you got to start with both Blitz Ra's to have both block. But if you do that start and you take 3 rerolls, you don't get a ball handler your first game. Any of your guys are ball handlers just like your Throw Ra's. The Throw Ra just comes with the built-in reroll with Sure Hands.
Right.
Normally what I'll do, especially in league play, is I'll start with 2 rerolls, and I'll start with both Blitz Ra's and a Throw Ra, and then I'll just work myself up to getting a third reroll. Usually what you'll do is you're going to take leader pretty quick on a Throw Ra anyway, which gives you that third reroll then.
Right.
So that's usually how I try to play it out. Just depends on what you're really trying to accomplish with them. If you're just doing a quick, you know, one-off tournament, then the third reroll is better. Right off the bat.
What skills do you normally start with?
Hold on, let me finish my turn and I'll tell you.
That's right. Ooh, again. I'll be quiet now.
Breaking.
You gotta yell at your double skulls.
Break right there would have been nice. No such luck.
I was just annoyed because I wanted to It was a misclick. I'm pretty sure I did that. Well, so far a good turn for keeping my players alive.
This is the one I want to break. Come on, baby. Break him. Break him. Ah. Lucky ass.
Are you doing the score happy?
I am not, no. Hey, Atomic.
Tim, are you?
No. Just lack of time.
Yeah.
I mean, due to helping out and wanting to do, you know, other people out, I ended up in 9 leagues.
Holy crap.
Yeah, I'm cutting down drastically.
You know they have 12-step meetings for, you know, Blood Bowl. I'm powerless over Blood Bowl. My life has become unmanageable.
Kind of feels that way at times.
That's a lot of hours.
Yes.
I think I'm going to stay right there, because that won't allow him to move down to get the assist here.
I was just going to cut back to
so
Goblin,
just get a one die here.
I decided to try USAB again.
If he comes
again.
Up for the assist here, you can only get a one die there.
I appreciate that.
I like that. Alright, so starting skills for the Tomb Guardians, the obvious skills, if you roll doubles, you take block at any point in time. If you roll regulars, it's normal progression is Mighty Blow first, then guard, then probably stand firm or break tackle, depending on how you want to do them. Double sixes, you definitely would take the strength six. Anything else, I wouldn't even worry about. I mean, you could do dodge. If you're going to take any doubles besides double sixes, if you're going to take dodge, which is about the only skill I'd take outside of block, I definitely wouldn't take dodge until you have block on them for sure. If you got block and you roll doubles again, you could take dodge and then give them break tackle after that, so they have that's a good cage breaker. But other than that, the only doubles you're really going to use outside of double sixes is for block. Throw Roz, block, fend is really good, leader on one of them is good. The obvious pick is Edge Bump, if you can get it. Strength Bump on one is really good, you can make him a defensive safety at that point. And it's a Strength 4 ball carrier at the same time, which is good. Kickoff Return is good as a later skill to give him the extra movement to get to the ball. Besides that, Blitz Roz, you're going to make your normal kill pieces, which would be, I always go Mighty Blow first just to get them to be able to get to those skills quicker because they start with block. So Mighty Blow, Tackle, Frenzy, Piling On, Guard is a late skill. Double sixes would be an obvious choice to get to the Strength 5, or Strength 4, I mean, sorry. You could take dodge with doubles, but I wouldn't. I would take, I would probably take something like jump up first, just so, especially on your piling on piece, so that way if you pile on, you can jump up and get the full six range movement on them. Skeletons, I usually go with, my first one would be a dirty player. And then I'll do, after that I'll do one with block. My third or fourth one I'll give wrestle. I'll give kick to either my, normally it's my dirty player when he gets a second skill, unless he rolls doubles for sneaky get. I'll give kick to the dirty player. But block tackle is a good progression with, you know, one or two of them. Guard if you get doubles. That's basically your normal skill shot.
How many extra skeletons do you carry?
I normally only carry a 12-man roster, so what I'll have is I'll have all four Tomb Guardians, both Blitz Roz, both Throw Roz, for 8, and then I'll carry four skeletons. Sometimes I might carry a fifth, depending on where I'm at. But when you get really high team value, like 2,000 plus, if you're carrying 14 or 15 guys, you're going to bloat up so quick. So to manage that bloat, I usually just go with 12.
Okay.
And just take your chances. Some guys don't, though. Some guys will take 13 or 14 and they'll foul with their skeletons, because skeletons make great foulers. And that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that at all.
You just don't carry the dirty player and foul with him, and that's it?
Yeah, that's the only one I'll foul with if he gets kicked off. Unless it's just a really great opportunity to foul, then I won't foul with any others. And I'm usually I kind of time my fouls. I don't just go foul normal people. It depends on the time of the game, where I'm at, and what pieces on the ground, but I normally won't foul unless I at least have a couple of assists on a good player.
Right. What are you going to say, Tim?
I know Spider runs a really thin team. Most people do run the 13-14. But team value-wise, they can start skyrocketing.
I guess it kind of depends on the game, too, because the skeletons are so cheap. You can buy a couple, right?
I just want to break him.
Yes.
That's it.
No, I've tried him in the champion ladder, and I've been getting crushed. It's been not fun. Especially playing a new team against, like, elves.
They are a tough team to play.
Oh, that's a break.
Someone try him in killing ground.
Oh, KO's good enough, baby.
Popcorn got popped.
KO is good enough. Popped that kernel, didn't I? Is that like popping that pussy? Sure feels like it. Oh, man. Oh, that's my sneaky git over there, isn't it? Yep. Oh, man. Do I let my sneaky git get surfed? Take the chance on the one die foul here? I do. I take the chance on the one die foul. Because even if he surfs him, if this guy stands up, he gets surfed, obviously. And if not, I can always resurf the wolf. Definitely gonna take a chance here, especially with the niggled white. Oh, I don't break. So here's the thing, he's gotta surf him, and he's gotta blitz with him so he can dodge out.
That was downright mean.
Or he's fucked. Yeah, that's what a lot of players do, Atomic. They go with that 13 on that magic number. All right, so let's see. He's down to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 players on the pitch. 4 KOs. I got 1 KO. Yeah, that's exactly what he had to do. And he does it with a 1 die, too. Ugh. No break. That's good. And he fails to dodge. Perfect. Blow your reroll. He's got two left, so now he's down to one. Double fail? Oh. He would have got fouled on if he'd have double failed that. But he's got to leave him down now. He's got a guard here, so he can hit him. Yep. And that'll mark up my move 8. Yep. Oh, why didn't he follow up? Now my move 8 can come hit. One die there. He doesn't have block. His reroll's gone, so that's a turnover. neither one of us get hurt. So let's stand him up first. This is mighty blow.
Yeah, I think me stopping Spider here is going to be a little bit tough.
Yeah, no takedown. That sucked.
You can do it.
All right, this is block hit here. No break.
But I knew coming into this match it was going to be a tough matchup.
I think I do the go for it here first to get the hit on him. Actually, I come this way and get the three die on him. I'll just let the white stand up. I don't care about that. I'd rather have three dice here if I can make a go for it and a chance to get this wolf out. There we go. Break him. Ah, damn it. Damn it. You were supposed to break him. It's a good hit there. I'll follow. Oh, that's a break. Oh, no stun though. So he could dodge one, but I do have diving tackle. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wait a minute, he's got 5 move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So he can't mark me. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Unless he goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I do have sidestep here, so nothing to worry about there. You have to dive into a tackle zone with diving tackle, and then out of one. Wait a minute, didn't he use a... Oh, he had three rerolls when he used that reroll.
I am playing a human team in that league.
It's turn six. I still have plenty of
time. And that's part of the issue is I just... I mean, I like him. I'm willing to help him out, but it's just too many leagues.
I'm okay with letting it stay here.
He asked me, but he never got back to me.
Hey, Swerve. Welcome in. Long time no see, man. He's almost got to do this dodge blitz here. He could blitz here, but that's uphill. On either one of these guys is uphill. But if he gets away with the first one, it goes into a one die. The likely choice would be the sidestepper. Oh, he does a one die up here instead. He did side block on that guy, though, so that wasn't too bad of a one die. Yeah, so me and Oni are actually playing here. Oni's Necro, my Lizards, but this is in OCC, Orca-Cola, the European League. We happen to get matched into the same division, so he is going to do the uphill here. Oh, he gets the yellows, but it's no takedown. But he will go into a one die now. And let's see here, so if I sidestep here...
At least this gets it down to a one die block.
I sidestep here actually. Oh, he gets the yellow anyway. And then I come here. So now he has a dodge out of it. Still has a dodge out. Well, he got lucky on that uphill. But I'm okay with that. I am going to hit the wolf with Mighty Blow this time. Put him over here. So nothing there. Move 8. And that's my blocker.
Yeah, more than likely I'm this upcoming season, I'll be doing USAB and Proving Grounds, and that's it.
Yeah.
This is turn 7, okay. I do still have a reroll, good. So I'll get the 3 die here. And the mighty blow hit, hopefully, on the Claw Wolf. If things go right. Oh! Oh, man.
Oh, I bet you that gets... No, I don't think he'll reroll here.
Do I greed it? I can't greed it as much as I want to. I just follow because he's still in a bad spot here. He's uphill on any of these. Or if he dodges out, he's got diving tackle on him. I can't greed that as much as I want to. Oh! 5 straight pushes. Fuck me. Let's push him further away so he can't do no goofy dodging.
Oh, so where are you at on the, my teams?
That's one.
Doing the mummies right now. You said you needed the werewolf. Oh, nice.
He regens, though. Ah! Could have failed the regen.
Hey, it doesn't matter now. I mean, a werewolf, a ghoul, and a zombie would be great, but I've...
2 points on him, though.
We started a new season, so I'm just playing some teams that I already have.
That's nice. Two points on him. Gets him closer to block, at least. 24. He has not blocked, so the better bet is this one, so I can take him down and move him in to mark him, hopefully. There we go. Stands firm, that's fine.
Oh, a bonehead right here would be really nice.
No, it wouldn't. Bonehead would be absolutely terrible. I don't want to do that. I think I go this way to get him closer in. Thank you, Crux.
Ah, boo.
Good Cruxy. Good Fago. That was huge, because he could have blitzed him with block and had 3 dice. No, it would have been 2 dice. 4-on-2. He still could if he wants to do the... 50% dodge. Be a gutsy good dodge, but he definitely could do it. And then 2 go forts on top of it. Yeah, that's what he's gonna do. Fail a dodge. He almost has to, though. It's really about his only chance he has. Fail a dodge, baby. Fail a dodge. There we go. Oh, prehensile tail. That's a 5+, not a 4+. If it wasn't for the tail, he would have made the first one. You would have made the dodge if it wasn't for the tail on that first one. Tail stopped you on the first one.
Yeah.
Alright, so it is turn 8, but I will do the... Oh, I don't have 3 die there anymore. Shit.
That's I wasn't sure how else I could stop you.
I'm still going to do this hit. I got to reroll. Ah, come on. Hey, hey, hey. I could blitz him, or could surf him. As long as I don't double skull, I'm good. I don't mind doing these hits with the reroll. If I don't score, it's not the worst thing.
I forget how much money I have now.
Because of all the KOs. I got block, he's got block.
Well, if everything goes right, I get 2 KO rolls.
I got block, he doesn't. Oh, I break! Oh, just a stun. Damn. That would have been nice. Oh, man, I could surf his ass. Boy, that'd take some gutsy dice, though. I'm half tempted to try to surf you with my reroll. I mean, I was wondering. If I don't score, at least you only get one roll at the KOs, right?
I was wondering about that.
Oh, it's so fucking risky, but so tempting. Fuck it. Yeah, there's no sense in doing that hungry. So Mountain Dew Code Red could get the biggest hit of the game and the score for the touchdown. Nice.
Just so you know, I hate you, Spider.
Come on, crowd. Come on, crowd. Ugh, fucking crowd doesn't like me, though. Ugh.
Well, both crowd pushes resulted in a stun.
Yeah, it seems like every... I've watched some of Sage's games, and almost every surf he does, he gets casualties on. I can't tell you the last time I got a casualty on a surf. It's probably been at least 20 surfs ago. I just never get the cross on the surf.
Well, you can start next game.
That's why I don't overly go overly aggressive to try to surf, because I never get crosses on him. It's always just a stun. Nice, my KO comes back. Oh shit, I did it so fast I didn't see his. I got 3 out of 4. Not bad.
Oh, I failed all of them? Oh no.
No, you
never
got
mind.
3 out of 4.
Your flesh golem's on the sideline.
Three out of four actually helps you quite a bit. Shit. This sucks. I gotta leave somebody up there to get hit. Two people, actually. And they're gonna get fouled at that.
I'm wondering who the sacrificial lambs are.
Tail, sidestep, and diving tackle. Actually, he's move 8. Yeah, actually, he's just gonna have to bite the bullet and go on the line. I want the sidesteppers on the side so he can't one turn. Sidestep, sidestep. Yep, perfect. Because then I can push where I want to go.
Oh, sacrificing the skinks.
He can't. He can't pull that one turner off. Yep, I don't want you to one turn. So Code Red gets the touchdown. Man, I needed him to not have good KO rolls, and he had 3 out of 4. Oh, that sucks. So, looking like this game's probably going to be a 1-1 draw. Unless my armor rolls continue to take him off in the second half, and I'm able to get the numbers advantage again, it's most likely going to be a 1-1 draw. But, realistically, he was going to get 2 shots at the KOs. Most likely he was going to get 3 or 4 of them back anyway. If the numbers play out right, he was going to get...
Oh, you're making this tough.
So really, the only chance he's going to have... I mean, he can push the middle guy. That's his best chance he's going to have. He's got a frenzy, push the middle guy, and push that way. Probably should have put the Crocs up there. Would have made it a lot harder on the frenzy. But I didn't want him to get the claw hit and fouling. Foul the piss out of the Crocs. Which is what he probably would have done. This is where you wish they had the optional on dodge all the time going. Because now when he blitzes here, stumbles, he's able to just continually push. Whereas if it was optional, I could say, no, go ahead and take me down. And then he can't push no more and his one turn chance is done. But he's still going to have to make a shit ton of good dice to be able to pull it off. I mean, a shit ton of good dice. Oh, that... Well, he already had a reroll anyway, so that doesn't really matter. Because he's going to have to dodge...
If I'd have had a quick snap, I think I'd have gone for it.
He's going to have to do dodge through tackle zones and go for it with only an edge three-piece. Super, super tough. And that's after pushing three. Well, I know. He could push two with him. He could get it with two pushes on the move nine. So blitzes here, pushes him out. Instead, he's going to go for the hits. Interesting. You still could have easily made it if you had the dice. All you needed was two pushes. Blitz the middle guy.
Yeah, I was looking at that.
Your hardest part would have been the dodges and go for it with edge 3.
Yeah, it's 5 plus, 4 plus, 3 plus. I think I went to the wrong square. This way I maximize my stats.
The zombie pass. Hey, Railson.
Okay, rack them up.
All right, let's hope my skink.
Well, that
comes
half
back.
Was disappointing for me.
Ah, stupid skink. Oh, did he fail his too? I shouldn't be muted. Oh, we both did. Both rolled.
At least that's one less skink for you.
And one less zombie for you.
Yeah, a couple of those players I've kept on just because they came from somebody else.
Huh, what do I do here now, guys?
Charity cases.
This
Tidy Bowl Blue
sucks.
And me smart.
I
forget who I got them off of.
I think I just got a give a skink up for...
Were all your player adoption. Names capitalized there, Sam?
They should be, yeah. You didn't get any players off of me. All my players' names are sodas.
Seriously?
Yep. That's my theme.
Faygo?
Hell yeah. You don't know what Faygo is?
Neither that or Sundrop.
You've never been in Detroit if you don't know what Faygo is. Sundrop's St. Louis area soda.
Big as like knee high.
Yeah, it's like Big K, even cheaper than Big K.
It's what the Juggalos drink.
Hell yeah. Faygo.
Woof woof.
Send your mama straight up to the store. Tell that bitch to bring home a Faygo.
I played two big games up in Ypsilanti, so we flew up to Detroit, but it was
Railston.
Fly there and drive somewhere else.
2 to 3 weeks should be. We're in the second week of the playoffs right now, and there's still 4 games left. The deadline is this coming Monday for it. And then there will be 2 more weeks after that. So 2.5 weeks for the deadline, and then give probably a week to get tickets sent out and everybody in and the league started. So 3 weeks most likely. Nah, you're not gonna miss it this week. Definitely won't be this week for sure. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and he's gonna have 11 because he had a large bench.
I'm gonna try a Kimry game.
What teams do you look forward to playing as Kimry?
And so, we shall go to war!
You're not asking me, are you?
Oh no, Spider.
Ooh, both teams lose turn, nice. I'm sorry, I didn't hear you, what'd you say? Oh, great.
What
kick.
Teams do you look forward to as Kimry?
Really, the worst team for me with Kimry is Dark Elves and Chaos Dwarf.
The mighty platypus has connected.
Most people hate to see Amazons. I actually don't mind playing Amazons, especially if I have a built Kimry team. If it's a rookie Kimry team, then Amazons suck ass. But if I have a built team, Amazons don't bother me at all just because the armor. And you're going to
Why, what are the Amazons
out of
do?
They're all dodge across the board.
Oh, okay.
So with only 2 block pieces to start and no tackle pieces to start, Amazons are an absolute nightmare for Kimry. They just dodge away from everything. But they're all armor 7 as well, so you have some a built-up team with some tackle and Mighty Blow, and you're gonna demolish a Amazon team over the length of a game. Dark Elves usually tend to be my worst matchup with Kimry. For some reason, I just can never seem to do good against Dark Elves. Wood Elves, Skaven, I usually do good against, but it comes down to can they pull off goofy shit at the end to win it? Because I'm going to take pieces off throughout the game. High Elves are kind of either way. The big bash teams that can get claw access, they scare me a little bit just because of the claw on the Tomb Guardians, but really not that bad. Come on, Crocs, take it.
Yeah, I get to play another Kimry.
Oh, damn it, Faygo.
Kimry on Kimry's boring as hell.
Shit! Still too much game to go with those mighty blow claws out there. It's only a badly hurt. Really would have liked to have gotten a skill on him, though, man. All I needed was one freaking casualty. Not gonna be this game. Oh, he puts his nickel piece out there for me. Is he gonna foul him? Oh, double fail.
I was scared of that.
I might not foul this guard piece now. Or blitz him, I mean. I was planning on blitzing him, but yeah, I may change my mind on that, because that's my move 8 there. Oh, fuck yeah.
Oh, you only came in with 11 players, right?
Yep. Oh, baby. My move 8 is going to get all the way back there. Song on my mind now.
Oh, yeah, there was a reason why I ran those players back.
Really love move 8. Such a great, great player. Man, I don't want these guys to be moving around though. Hopefully I dodge here. Dodge here and here to mark him off. Strength 5 marks him off. He comes over and marks him off. Neither one of those guys are guard.
Well, that 5 strength guy is a pain. What's his next skill? Mighty Blow or Frenzy?
Mighty Blow, probably. I don't know. We'll see. Depends on what he rolls. Do I? Man, oh man, oh man, oh man. I need to get a skink back here for sure. I think it's the sneaky get guy. That way I can use him to mark with the sidestep.
How far is the drive for both of y'all to get to Chaos Cup?
For 4 hours and 20 minutes or so for me.
6 for me.
Not on this team, Dip. This is a actual private league team, the OCC team. So it's a themed team. It's the Lizorka Men Cola Guzzlers. So it's Orca Cola is the league. So that's why Orca Cola's there. And then it's Lizard Men and they're guzzling cola. And then the player names are all after sodas. Dr. Pepper, Sun Drop, Mellow Yellow, Sun Kissed, Sprite, Coke, blah, 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 so on and so forth. And then all the skinks are energy drink sodas like Mountain Dew Code Red, Monster, Jolt, and Red Bull. And then my Crocs is Faygo, which is a Detroit soda.
How do you like Sunkissed?
I'm not a big fan of Sunkissed.
Even with plus 2 movement?
Make some dodges, there you go. Do what?
Even with the plus 2 movement?
Oh, I thought you were talking about the actual sunny soda. I love Sunkissed. Make another dodge. There we go. Perfect.
I bet you that has surprised a lot of people.
So he's marked off now unless he dodges, which I'm okay with if he does. Actually, he's not sidestep shit. Would really be nice is to go here. And I still have my dodge skill, and he's sidestep. Perfect. Now he can't dodge out through any of that shit. Somebody's got to blitz him off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Pass it up. He could do that. That's alright. I'm okay with this setup. I think this is good. I think this is good. Problem is, I'm gonna have to get a pal on this guy because I don't have any tackle. Block won't work because he's already got block. He's gonna mark here, which is the smartest move he could do. Do the hit there. Yep, that's three die. Gets the both down. That's fine. Ah, and he breaks. Well, I put him out there for it, so I can't be mad about that. Now I can blitz here if he wants. Nice. Push him off. Yep. Yep. Now he can blitz with either one. He might come in here and put the guard in so he can get the two die there, maybe. Ah, no, he's going to go down that route instead. And then it'll blitz him with him. A double fail on the pickup would be nice. See another one of those. That would be pretty darn cool. Oh wow, he's not gonna blitz? Or is he gonna dodge out and blitz here? Oh, he's gonna dodge out and blitz there. Yep. Fail the dodge. Come on, fail it. Ah! Lucky ass. Lucky ass. Don't break. Oh, and he injures. Stupid fucking claw.
I'm kinda lucky on that.
Oh man, I gotta be missed next game with a source now. Still too long to go, I can't use it. Ah! Stupid wolves. Oh, he's just gonna stay there? Interesting. Come on, double fail this. That would be so nice. If he double fails this, he's could be in big trouble. Oh, he double fails it!
Oh, holy wow. Holy shit.
I was just sitting there saying, man, if he double fails this, he could be in big trouble. No block there.
I thought I did everything right.
Block there. Oh, I can't hit him, though. Damn it. I think I just take my chance on a 4-plus pickup. That's a blocker.
50-50, 75% chance with a reroll.
Yep.
Scotch has connected.
I can't think of anything else I could have done. Maybe
Scotch has left
the run server. In front of you?
Yeah, the only thing you could have done was try to get in front of the skink where the skink would have to make dodges and stuff. Oh, shit! And he stays dead. No regen. Oh. Well, at least it was the rookie.
Yeah, it's just annoying.
Yeah. I mean, he didn't have any SPPs. It would have really sucked if he had 5 SPPs and was really close.
Well, it's just annoying due to how expensive they are.
Yeah.
And I don't have enough to replace them.
Yeah, that's true. Very good point.
But at least you're right. It was the rookie. And it was the Mighty Blow that got you the casualty.
Yep. It was. And thankfully it was him and not one of your wolves.
Yes.
There is that. Is that the Niggled? That is not. That's the Niggled.
Well, at least he can't do anything. Yeah, I don't feel like I did anything wrong. I just failed four pickups.
I really want to do this hit on this Niggle piece. Ugh.
That would be tough to get a draw.
That would suck ass. Fuck it. Shoof. Yeah, I don't want to risk that dodge. Well, all I need is a 50% with a reroll, so 75%. Come on, Skink, for the win. Nice.
Nothing
nice,
I could do.
Nice, baby. Yeah.
The problem is, if I ran the werewolf around the other side, you can still blitz and get to the ball.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's what I would have done. I would have blitzed him. Come on, come back, come back, come back. Oh, damn it. Well, I guess I can't complain. I'm up 2-0. That guarantees me the win. I don't think there's any way he can get a win out of this now. But I'm going to take more hits. Claw hits now, which is going to suck ass.
I think I have a shot at tarawing the game, though.
This really fucking blows ass. I have to keep both of my guys, or all my sources safe. Put them all back here where you can only get a one die on them. Unless he makes a lot of go forts. Put the strength in the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, he can get guard that way too, so let's move him back one more. That way he's got to make go forts with the whites to get assists. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Then he could bring the other wolf around, but that would only give him one die. Yeah, I like that. Let's go with that. And that was Monster that got the touchdown. I hate scoring with the sneaky get, but that's really the only choice I had right there. I had to get the score. He could still pull off a draw, but he's got to score super, super quick. And have everything go right for him as well. Because then after that, all I'm going to do is try to play keep away with the ball to make it even harder for him. Looks like he's lost connection. Ah, you could have done it all at the same time, Shameless. Oh. Oops, I missed a call. Ah, there he is, he's back. Yay, Ferroni. Alright, give me a second, guys. I'm gonna call the wife back here and see what she wanted.
Shunter has connected. Shunter joined your channel.
Hello.
Alright. Sorry about that, guys. Wife just let me know she was on her way home. Well, that helps him a little bit. Although it's only going to give him... Oh, that gives him a lot of movement, actually.
Do you have the kick skill?
I do not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Those are two pretty damn good kicks, though, aren't they? Oh, he catches it this time. At least you don't have to try to pick it up now.
I'm glad for that.
Gunter, are you looking for a game?
Yeah, I can quit my ladder match. What team value?
Let me look.
Ah, nice. Three dice saves him. Super skink, taking the shots like an absolute stud. Wow! Six straight dice miss. Oh, you gotta love it. And he finally gets him. That's pretty nice. Sucked up 8 blocks before he goes down. Super stud skink right there.
I know, that was...
Oh, and then that one takes the
first
hit.
Not what I was hoping for.
Now he's gonna take the claw. This sucks.
Camera angle's different there, Spider. Where'd you move the computer altogether?
Oh, I think I was muted, sorry. No, I didn't move the computer, I just moved the camera up and away from me a little bit so it wasn't straight in my face. Ugh! Fuck me, Claw!
He is going crazy.
3 for 4 on Claw. Oh, another miss next game. God damn it.
What should happen in the first half?
Ugh!
So far, no perms, though, so that's good.
I'm 15-20.
Yeah, but two miss next games. Fuck. Now I'm going to be without two source next game. I don't even know who I play. I don't mind that he's breaking, but God, they could be badly hurts. Come on, ref, catch him. Catch him, ref. Ah, he doesn't get caught. Two fouls without getting caught now. Man. What the hell?
So it looks like I'll be keeping the niggled white a little bit longer.
I'm basing all men's here and hoping to God he doesn't kill nobody. Gotta try to slow him down at least if I can. He's getting too many takeoffs. Ugh, fucking two missed next game source sucks. One's just a rookie, but the move eight's gonna hurt. At least I'll have all of my, so far, as of right now, I'll have my three mighty blow blocks. Gonna really suck if those don't come out, or if those don't come back for the next game. Yep, move him around. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, wow. Bring him in for the assist here and then take him down.
You still want to play open?
Then you can bring
absolutely,
him in with
sir.
The guard.
What was the team value you're looking
blitz
at?
Out.
15-20. I'm sorry, I mentioned that earlier.
Are you going to dodge out, I guess?
15-20? Yeah, let me go find a team. Let me quit.
Ah, you...
Spider, we're okay talking over on your stream?
No.
So our chat goes through.
Yeah, if you guys don't mind,
I'll move.
Go up to another channel, just so we don't have a bunch of chat going on.
Yes, sir.
Shunter left your channel. Gunter OLB.
Man, his armor breaks are tearing me apart channel. Now, man. Fuck. Absolutely tearing me up, man. Jesus Christ. Oh, he's going to try to push him. Does that push into a go for it? But it pushes into a one die. Oh, sweet. Come on, skull out. Skull out, bitch. Ugh. Ugh, stupid wolf. He does get himself. Well, he's not out of safety now, actually. He will be here, though. No takedown here would be good. Nothing else. At least the wolf's in hit zone now, unless he scores. No reroll to make go for it, though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, no go for it.
Kind of want to give myself three turns to score.
He'd either have to dodge, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, dodge and a go for it, or two go for it. And he's still got to make the catch, too. Makes the catch, just barely. Two go for it's are better. Come on, fail one of these babies. Let me get that free hit on that wolf.
You know how much I hate this part?
Tripwire. Can anybody spell tripwire? You deserve
okay.
It after all the casualties you're doing.
If you had to make a bet, which one do I fail?
The second one. There's no doubt. If it was me, I'd fail the first one, because I always fail my first go for it when I gotta make two. But everybody else almost always fails the second one, especially over the goal line.
I almost want to stall because I hate making that damn roll.
I can guarantee you I'm rooting against you.
I understand that.
I hope he does stall just so I can get one mighty blow hit on that wolf. That would be so freaking nice.
Well, if I want to draw.
Oh, he made them both. Nicely done.
Whew.
And he saves the hit on the wolf.
That was a good defense considering the number of players you had.
The biggest thing that you saved there was you saved your mighty blow hit on your wolf.
Yes.
That saved you the most in that whole sequence of play.
Well, I knew I had to push my guy to have a really good shot.
Ugh, I got five players. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Good golly. You want to talk about ugly? This right here is ugly. He's got three turns to try to rush the ball and get downfield and score. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 on 3. Or 5, I mean. 11 on 5. His armor breaks the last four turns have just absolutely obliterated my team. If I get the win, it's going to be a costly one. At least there are no perms. It's just my miss next games at this point, but still.
I didn't realize you were down to so few players.
That's what happens when you break armor every hit. And take off the pitch every hit. You haven't had one stun this half, I think. Every single armor break you've had has taken somebody off.
Oh, wow, that's brutal.
So we'll do that.
You know what that's called, Sam?
We'll do this. It's called good armor rolls.
Coaching skill.
Something like that.
That's what I'm gonna go with.
Wait a minute, I thought I just moved him over there, damn it. Alright. Here goes nutting.
Time to nut up or shut up.
My magic dome saves the day there.
I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
Ooh, perfect kick. Perfect kick. Actually, I wish it would have bounced here.
I've definitely had some good rolls on the player removal.
If it would have bounced there, it would have been perfect, because now I can't move him into my cage until I pick the ball up. But this is the plan. We'll go ahead and take the takedown. Ah, break would have been nice. Well, it all comes down to a pickup. Ah, come on. Fuck me, really? Pick the ball.
Uh-oh, big pickup roll.
Shoof. That could have been nasty, nasty, nasty. All right. He's got to pick the corners off. And then I'm going to have to make dodges after that. Is he going to come after that side? It's interesting. Yes, please. Do the go for it. Pretty, pretty, please. Pretty, pretty, please. With sugar and icing on top. No, just putting those two pieces there means that's only a one die. So, smart play. Forces me into an iffy dice roll. This is what you want to do. Mark up everybody. Put your guard here. That makes him a one die here. It would be a two die there, though. But it gives you guard on him. Now you can blitz here. The strength 5. You don't even need that assist. Not sure why you did that. Because he's already negative there. Oh, yeah, you did actually need it. Sorry, I'm afraid. I was wrong there. Absolutely did need it because he's strength 5. So it's 3, 4, 5, 6. perfect scenario would be him failing the first one and having to push him out one. Well, he could still come right back in, though. Block, block, he's got to push. Oh, it rerolls. Oh, wow. Why reroll? Why reroll that? Why not just push it?
It would have put me at a one die block.
No. Oh, yeah, it would have. With the guy in the middle, you're right. Wasn't thinking about the ball carrier. Good point. Alright, so now what the fuck do I do? I'm at a one die everywhere. One die there, two.
If I'd have gone the other way, I'd been fine, because I would have put my flesh golem there to get the two die block.
One die. Uphill, one. So, good news is I got a reroll, and all my pieces have block. Yeah. If you want to call that.
Yeah, you're not in a great spot.
Ugh, the very first fucking blocks of skull. Jeez. Do I follow here? Do I follow?
No. Not in a bad spot now, though, either.
Oh, break there would have been nice.
All right. It'll be tough to see what you do. I mean, it'll be interesting to see what you do, but...
Evil Smirk has connected.
That's a good break. I'll take that. One less guy he can use. He was very smart to put that guy back, because I can't just flush up the field now. So we go one die here. Two die, one die. If I fail that, he just blitzes right in. Hey, Narian. I mean, he's gonna get the hit anyway and blitz in anyway. I really would like to get him down. The only way I can do that is to mark. And that would be absolutely stupid. He is sidestep. If I did come in here and mark here, which would allow me a one die on him, or if I came in here...
Oh, Mr. Red Bull is still out there.
That would give me a two die on him. Then he'd get a free hit. I could sidestep back here, but that ball could bounce anywhere. Yeah, I can't mark. I gotta stay there. I gotta make him blitz me. No block. I think I just stay here and make him do the hits. It's the best I can do, right? Because even if he hits this guy and gets him down, he's got to get a great bounce. And then he's still got to pick the ball up. And go most of my part of the field to score. probably does the hit here first so we can move in and take the assist away here to do this hit. Nope, he doesn't. Wow. So he's got to take the both down or reroll. Or go into a one die. And he's going to go into the one die. Come on, Skull. Skull it. Ugh. Gosh, dang it. Oh, at least he didn't break for a change. That's nice. Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. Looky here, looky here. Do the hit here. Bring him in for the assist to do the hit there. Blitz here with the block. I have to push this way to keep the ball from bouncing out around here. Oh, wow. Use him for the blitz. Why not use him for the blitz? You're going to blitz with the move piece? I think he is. He's going to blitz with the move piece. Interesting. Yeah, I did win a game earlier with him, Anarian. So 1-1-0. Oh, no, he's going to blitz in with him. Interesting. I wouldn't have done it that way, because you take a chance with no skilled player doing the block there, but he wanted the three dice on him, which I get. Now I just got to have this ball bounce right. Ah, he breaks and injures. Nice. Just a badly hurt. Come on, ball. Bounce good. That's good enough. That's good enough, ball. It's good enough for me. He doesn't want to do this hit now because it's putting another guy on the ball. I'm okay with that. He does have two dice here. Oh, he's going to dodge out instead. Fail a dodge. At least have to use no. Did he use a reroll already? I can't remember if he used a reroll this turn or not. But this is actually not bad. If I can take this skeleton down, I'll be okay.
Oh, 1 in 3 you go down, 1 in 3 I go down.
He's got to do the... Oh, no, he doesn't. That's just a one die. Yeah. I wouldn't do it. Wouldn't do it. He doesn't have block on that piece. Actually, it's a 1 and 2 I go down, because I got block and you don't.
Well, no, both.
You only take me down with yellows.
Yeah, that's 1 and 3.
Yeah, you're right. 1 and 3. Sorry, I'm thinking 1 and 2. Yeah, and 1 and 3 for you too as well. Right, you're right. All right, so we stand him up. Blitz here.
Well, I'm trying to make this a game.
Blitz here. Come down and mark the ball. He can score with no go for it. He can score with one go for it.
I kept 5 strength, boy. There, that's the one that decided a lot. That block right there was the 5 strength.
Do this, stand him up. Do this hit here to get him off the ball, or off the source. I mean, perfect. Break him would be nice. Ah. That was the niggled one, too. Oh, that would have been so nice. Gotta re-roll it. There we go. Make sure I follow. Oh, that's a good break. Now, do I come here and mark the ball? Or do I come here and mark the white? Because he can bring these two over to hit him and get him off. Hit him and try to scatter the ball. even if the ball scattered out here, he'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
You're definitely making it a little trickier than I would like.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So he could get there. If I do this, that at least forces him to dodge. And if he pushes and scatters the ball, if the ball came out to one of these, he could easily pick it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oh, he couldn't score that way, though.
Yeah, that's a good question where he should go.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. He has to have that ball scatter in this direction. Problem is, if I stay here and he scatters the ball, then it could hit me and bounce out even closer to the end zone to help him. If I move him down to here, then that ball can't scatter onto my body. Yeah, I think that's the better play here. Because then it at least makes him have to dodge as well. He can't do no goofy-ass pickup handoff, and he just waltzes in for the score. Now he has to catch in a tackle zone, dodge out of a tackle zone. I think that's the better play. It gets my body off this line so the ball can't bounce on it. Yeah, that's tough. I think that's the better play because now my body's off that line against the ball, so the ball can't bounce on him and then bounce out closer to the goal line. And it takes away your goofiness of just being able to somehow pick the ball up and then hand it off to the white and he waltzes in untouched. At least now you'd have to catch in the tackle zone, dodge out.
Or dodge out and end up passing.
Yeah. That'd probably be the better play, right? Or he could dodge out here and come around and try to blitz me. But that would require a couple go-forts here to get an assist. And a dodge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 8.
I have a lot of words for him right now.
Well, the only reason you're even having this chance is because of all the armor breaks you got the first four turns of this half. But those were good armor breaks. That claw guy did his job. He's single-handedly kept you in this game with a chance to do it.
Yes.
So there's the two die to scatter the ball. Oh, nice. There goes the reroll. That's nice. That was quite unexpected. And he doesn't take him down. That's even better. Gotta scatter it. I need that ball to bounce here or here. Here would be better. Oh, perfect. Perfect bounce. This is nigh on impossible now. No, don't bounce here. Bounce here or here. Or even over here. Perfect. Oh, the ball scatters just saved my ass. Yeah, you'd have to roll a whole shitload of sixes.
Yeah, I think congratulations. I'll say congratulations on the win, but I can still take it. Ay, 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 ay. I was even saving Tidy Bowl to be able to do a pass or a handoff or something.
Ah, sorry guys. Yeah, the ball scatter saved me.
I think you're a good play in that I just could not pick up the ball.
Yeah, that two turns of failing the pickups really hurt you for sure. But your Mighty Blow Wolf single-handedly kept you in this with all the takeoffs. It gave you the chance to even be where you're at now. If it wasn't for him, you're probably not even in this spot to have the chance. This is probably.
Alright, you ready
best
for
bet
some
here.
Miracles? And that double skull's there.
Yeah, that double skull's really hurt too. You had to blow the reroll.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah, good game, man. That was a fun one. For sure.
Yeah, I think a lot of the game came down to four. Inability to pick up the ball on a 3+ four times.
Ah, come on. Give me some casualties, damn it.
You played a good game, though, so I mean, I can't. As much as it is not fun to lose, at least you beat me.
Yeah, that at least helps me get back into the running here. I had to. If I didn't win this game, then I definitely wouldn't have been in the shot to get in the first two.
I still think I have a good shot, and I don't feel like I played.
I could have surfed your wolf, by the way, and I didn't. I could have took that zombie down with my strength 5 to free up Sprite and then surfed you. So I just want you to know that I did. I chose not to surf you.
Thank you.
If it would have been the other Tim, and we all know who I'm talking about, I would have done that in a heartbeat. I would have done that in an absolute heartbeat.
It's like the message that I posted was because I know you, I talked a little
bit. Oh, yeah. That was all fun and banter. I thought my retort was pretty good, too. I'm glad you did.
Oh, that's so annoying. I'm at 100K treasury.
Yeah. Oh, so you're just off of getting your mummy? Or your golem back?
I only had 10 armor bits.
Yeah, Swerve, it's always nice.
Oh, and that werewolf got the MVP. Wow, 10 armor breaks for 6 casualties is really...
Do I re-roll this? Ugh, it'd be nice to get a little more money. I mean, I don't need the money. I don't have to re...
No, you played a really good game. I mean...
My sneaky git steals the MVP. Motherfucker. I didn't want him to level. Jesus. Oh, that sucks. Stupid sneaky git. Maybe he'll roll doubles for dirty player. And he leveled a wolf. Oh, my next match is gonna suck.
So right now I'm currently in third.
Oh, no doubles. Alright, we'll go sidestep. So one of the things, I ate my APO that match, unfortunately. I really wish, and we've actually talked about this in the admin side. Actually, I think it might have even been on the regular forum, I don't remember. But anyway, what would be really cool is if they changed the APO to be, if you play the whole match without using it, any player that was permed or dead, you could have a reroll use, or you could use your APO then at that point on that one player. But what was the thing they said? I can't remember the exact restrictions. There were some restrictions on it, like if you had to take whatever. I think it was you had to take whatever the reroll was. So if it was just a, like a source took an edge break and I decided to try to reroll it. Then it was a dead, then I had to take the dead. I couldn't take the edge break.
Okay.
Something like that. But it would give you the chance. Like, if you chose not to APO a dead player, and you saved your APO through the whole game, at the end of the game, if you still had it, you could try to save your dead player, and if you re-rolled it into a badly hurt or missed next game, then that's what you had to take, and you save him. but it would give you that chance so you just don't absolutely waste your APO through the whole match. It'd be really cool if they, you know, if Games Workshop implemented some type of a addendum to the APO rule to allow something like that. Alright, so Monster got sidestep. That's 20k on him. And my two missed next games are Coke and Sunkissed. Ugh. Well, I might be getting inducements my next match. That'd be cool. We'll have to see who I play. I'm not even sure who I play yet.
So you play the Norse next.
Huh? Could be worse. We'll have to see what his team looks like. 60. Did I get a fan factor there? I did. 6.
You play a Norse team. And they're at 168.
Oh, wow, they're low. I'm still going to be giving them TV. Jesus. Oh, no, 168. That's 1680. Yeah, they're giving me TV. So, Swerve.
Lo, there do I see my father. Lo, there do I see my mother and my sisters and my brothers. Lo, there do I see the line of
my people. Back to the beginning.
Lo. They do call to me. They bid me take my place among them.
In the halls of Valhalla,
where the brave
may live.